Well, they are young and they don't have a care in the world, but their wild behaviour on our waterways is dangerous. Tonight, we're on patrol with police cracking down on teenagers in their tinnies.
It does seem to be getting worse, and the risk-taking seems to be getting a lot more prevalent.
One of these kids are getting killed, without a doubt.
They call them the tinny rats.
Well, they make a hell of a racket coming through here.
They are unlicensed under the legislation, straight up.
I've had kids here actually fall off their boats right outside here in front of me.
Too young to be identified, these teenagers and even children are breaking the law and endangering lives.
The type of activities that can very, very quickly turn bad.
Did you know that he was up to this kind of thing with his mates?
Not to this extent.
We're on board with the water police, who are urging kids and their parents to stop this risky behaviour.
We sort of gave in to the pressure of getting a bigger motor like most of the other parents have.
We're extremely concerned that people are going to be badly injured or perhaps worse.
On a fine sunny day, these Gold Coast canals can become like a busy highway of boats, jet skis, paddle boards and other watercraft. So when you've got hoons on the water, it can be a recipe for disaster. That's why these water police are cracking down.
Slow down, slow down, slow down, slow down.
Like many of the people who live on or use the Gold Coast canals, Sergeant Tony Nelson from the local water police is frustrated. He has to spend a lot of his time chasing after gangs of teenagers and some kids even younger who are out on their tinnies and running amok.
They treat it like a toy, and they push some boundaries, and they do conduct in some unlawful activity.
The rules for boaties using these waterways are clear. The speed limit is 6 knots or a brisk walking pace, and freestyling, any unpredictable manoeuvring, is banned. If you're 16 and don't have a boating licence, the size of your engine is limited to 6 horsepower.
A lot of young people have access to boats at a very young age.
But more and more, these kids are brazenly breaking those rules in dangerous fashion, and they're bragging about it on social media.
Misusing boats and vessels is obviously concerning in itself, but why do you think they then go and publish it on the internet?
They're proud of the stunts that they can do without having any regard to the consequences of their actions.
There are hours of footage posted by the kids online of them shamelessly breaking the laws, but they're not all kids. This man, who filmed himself swinging from a bridge in a tinny, looks old enough to know better. Under international maritime laws, boat operators must, for a start, maintain a clear line of sight ahead.
The way they're operating the boat, that is a vertical there now, they can't keep a proper lookout.
Concerningly, kids are even tampering with their boat engines to make them appear to be of legal size, like these ones, which the police have just seized.
They remove any stickers. Most boats will have... You can see this one's completely blank. Most will have a number on the back here, so that's been removed, which would have said 15, and then they'll try and pretend that it's a 6 horsepower.
Well, I've just come to collect my son. He's been fined and had his boat seized for the second time.
This mother had the unenviable task of collecting her son after he and his tinny, with its oversized engine, were towed back to the water police station.
I knew that none of them were sort of wanting a 6 horsepower motor because it's just not fast enough or good enough.
For his troubles, this woman's son was fined $700. She says he'll be selling the tinny to pay for it.
Is he in trouble?
He's going to be.
Out on the water, the tinny rats are making their presence known, and frustrated residents have had enough.
There are a lot of people here with cameras who take a lot of vision and provide that to us for follow-up.
Oh, it gets me fired up, all right.
This resident began providing police with security camera footage of people breaking the law. He says he's been threatened by a group of older water hoons on jet skis, so he's asked to remain anonymous.
I mean, I look forward to the guys turning around in their tinnies and their boats and their jet skis to have a word, because the words always turn into a big drama, a big conflict, and, you know, make a few threats here and there and they're off.
Almost on a daily basis, police are pulling up tinny drivers who don't have a licence and whose engines are more powerful than 6 horsepower. We came across this boat behind the Gold Coast's iconic Pacific Fair shopping centre. When Sergeant Nelson called the registered owner, sure enough, it was a woman who wasn't aware her son had taken off with the tinny.
She told me that it is a 15 horsepower outboard, that she bought it for him, that he is 16, but he has not got his licence yet.
When the teenage tinny rat turned up, he was given a stern warning and a direction to drive straight home.
Doing.
This driver was licensed, but he too was given a warning for not having a compliant life jacket.
You been behaving yourself today? You have?
Here was a tinny rat who'd been pulled up by police before.
So since September last year, I've got right here in front of me, 10 times that there's been activity recorded for police. And some of those are complaints about it speeding.
But being caught by police is nothing compared to what could happen as a result of driving boats dangerously. Adam is the captain of Surfers Paradise River Cruises. He's frustrated the constant wash caused by speeding boats damages his vessel when it's moored to a jetty.
It rubs the side of the boat up and down the side of the pile. There's a fixed structure here, so we're floating, but the jetty's not. So every time the boat rises and falls, that puts pressure on all our structure and all that as well, so.
But the last thing he wants is his boat to collide with an out-of-control tinny.
I mean, there's sandbanks everywhere. You hit a sandbank at 20 knots in a tinny like that, you're going a long way out the front of it, so. It's only a matter of time, unfortunately.
I have seen a person who fell out of his boat have his arm amputated. We're extremely concerned that people are going to be badly injured or perhaps worse.
The message from police is clear.
The courses of action that we have available to us as police only go a certain distance, and we really need the parents to come on board to help us.
Gold Coast Police were busy again over the Easter weekend with two separate jet ski crashes. One of the drivers has been charged with high-range drink driving, and several notices were issued for dangerous driving on the canals.